BGMC. The biblical truth lives here. Ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Let's go get a blessing. Shalom, everybody. Welcome to the City Gate Messianic Bible Study.
Vamos en busca de una bendición y shalom, shalom a todos. Bienvenidos a este estudio bíblico del portón de la ciudad.
This Bible study is being brought to you by Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation.
Este estudio bíblico ha sido traído por ustedes, a ustedes de parte de Beth Goyim, que es un ministerio mesiánico internacional.
We are located at 800 West 3rd Avenue in Lexington, North Carolina.
Estamos localizados en la en la 800 West de la calle 3rd Avenida de Lexington, Carolina del Norte.
That's 800 West 3rd Avenue in Lexington, North Carolina, where Jew and Gentile worship Yeshua as Messiah as one people.
Y eso está otra vez, una vez más, en la 800 West de la 3rd Avenida en Lexington, Carolina del Norte, y donde judío y gentil adoramos al Mesías como un solo pueblo.
We are streaming live on YouTube and also on our own web station called yeshuatube.org.
Estamos transmitiendo directamente y en vivo desde YouTube, pero también desde nuestra propia plataforma que se llama yeshuatube.org.
You are welcome to join us to be interactive on if you like to be part of the Bible study on WebEx.
Y te damos la bienvenida si quieres ser interactivo con nosotros en la plataforma WebEx.
All right, so this is part number one of the Messianic prophecies about Messiah.
Y esta es la parte número uno de este estudio bíblico de las profecías mesiánicas de Yeshua HaMashiach.
If you want to be interactive, if you're on WebEx now, turn on your camera so we can see your beautiful faces.
Y si quieres ser interactivo con nosotros, estás ahí en WebEx, por favor, enciende tu cámara para sentirnos que estamos juntos.
All right. This is going to be a long study. It'll be a bunch of weeks because I think it's very important right now.
Y este estudio va a durar mucho tiempo, creo que varias semanas, porque creo que es importante e interesante el tema.
Let's go on to slide number three. The Tanakh, the Old Testament prophecy is fulfilled by Yeshua.
Y este título se titula de esta forma, la Tanakh, y es el Antiguo Testamento, profecías que son cumplidas por Yeshua.
The Tanakh contains 351 prophecies that refer to the coming of the Messiah.
En la Tanakh se encuentran 351 profecías que se refieren a la venida del Mesías.
Yeshua, the Son of God, fulfilled these prophecies.
Yeshua, el Hijo del Altísimo, cumplió esas profecías.
These prophecies were written anywhere from a couple of hundred years to a thousand years before his birth as a man.
Y estas profecías están, fueron dichas cientos de años antes de su nacimiento e incluso miles de años antes de el nacimiento como hombre aquí en la tierra.
Okay. The Septuagint was translated from Hebrew to Greek at least 700 years before Messiah.
La Septuaginta fue es la traducción del hebreo al griego que se hizo aproximadamente unos 700 años antes de Yeshua.
Some people put it at 500 years, but so it's anywhere between 500 and 700 years before Messiah Yeshua.
Algunas personas lo colocan, datan, dicen que esta data es de unos 500 años antes de Yeshua, pero está entre ese rango de 700 años o 500 años antes de Yeshua.
Okay, let's go on the next slide. Once again, these prophecies were written way before Yeshua came to earth as a baby.
Y estas, una vez más, les decimos que estas profecías fueron dicho un tiempo muy largo antes de que él viniera como un baby, como un bebé.
Now, if you're looking at the slides on the screen,
si estás observando la diapositiva en la pantalla,
of these 351 prophecies,
que hay unas 351 profecías,
mathematically speaking, the odds are staggering that anyone would fulfill a small amount of the prophecies.
Y matemáticamente se comprueba como que las personas podían cumplir una pequeña porción de estas profecías.
Okay, one person fulfilling 8 of the prophecies.
Una persona cumplió unas 8 de estas profecías.
Is 1 to the, let's see how many zeros we got here. We got 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 17 zeros.
Y esto es uno de unos 100 millones, 100 trillones de en probabilidad.
Okay, so the probabilities are astronomical that somebody would fulfill 8 prophecies, 8.
Y esto es un número como astronómico, para decirlo así, de una sola persona haber cumplido 8 de todas las profecías del Mesías.
One person fulfilling 40 of the prophecies.
Una persona también cumplió unas 40 de todas estas profecías.
Is 1 in 10 to the 157th power.
Y eso es uno de 10 de los 157 en número para cumplir esto en poder.
One person fulfilling 351 of the prophecies, only Yeshua.
Y solamente una persona cumplió todas estas 351 profecías y su nombre es Yeshua.
So there's no, I mean, just to fulfill 8 of the prophecies, that's a ridiculous number right there.
Y es ridículo el número con solamente pensar que una persona pudiera haber cumplido 8 de todas estas profecías.
So we're going to be going over what I've decided to do.
Lo que he decidido hacer
is we're going to go first through the Torah.
Es que vamos a ir primero a la Torah.
So I was going back and forth on how to present the information to everybody.
Y no sabía cómo comenzar, estaba indeciso de cómo presentarle todo esto a ustedes.
Like, sometimes you can look at groupings like his birth or his healings or things like that.
Y a veces separamos lo que son sus hechos, como por ejemplo el lugar de nacimiento, sus sanidades y cosas como estas.
So the way I'm going to present this study,
pero la forma que voy a presentar este estudio,
is by going book by book through the Tanakh, the Old Testament.
Es que voy a ir revisando libro por libro, rollo por rollo, del Tanakh, del Antiguo Testamento.
So we're going to start off with one prophecy that is not directly about Mashiach, but it is a prophecy.
Y vamos a comenzar con una frase que no es directamente, prácticamente una de las profecías, pero realmente es parte de ella.
Turn in their Bibles to Bereshit, Genesis 1, verse 26.
Y si todos pueden acompañarme, por favor, a ir a Génesis 1, 26.
Genesis 1, verse 26.
Génesis, capítulo 1, verso 26.
Now, during this study, sometimes I'm going to use the NASB version, and sometimes I'm going to use the Complete Jewish Bible version.
Y en este estudio me voy a utilizar dos versiones distintas, la Biblia completa judía y la NSB.
The best translation, I believe, is the NASB version, the New American Standard Bible version of the Bible.
Esta última, la NASB, creo que es la versión más correcta de todas.
Because what they did is they went directly from the Hebrew in the Tanakh, and they went directly from the Greek in the Brit Hadashah, the New Testament.
Porque lo que estas personas hicieron en esta traducción fue irse directamente en la Tanakh, en el Antiguo Testamento, directamente del hebreo para hacer la traducción, y en el Brit Hadashah, Nuevo Testamento, se fueron directamente desde el griego.
And they had a large grouping of people that were linguists and language scholars.
Y tuvieron una gran cantidad de estudiosos y escolares que reforzaron este estudio.
To translate to get the best translation possible.
Para ellos poder obtener la mejor traducción posible.
So what you see on your screen right now is from the NASB in Bereshit Genesis 1 verse 26.
Y esta versión que estás mirando ahora es de la NASB que vamos a leer en este momento.
The only thing I would like to see the NASB do is change the names to the real Hebrew names. That would be a perfect version of an English Bible.
Y lo único que quisiera ver que la NASB hiciera es solamente cambiar los nombres a los nombres originales para hacer entonces la perfecta versión bíblica.
Okay, so Genesis 1 verse 26 says.
Y entonces leamos por favor Génesis 1:26. Dice así.
Then God, Elohim, said, "Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the sky, over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on earth." Okay, so we're keying at the beginning part in the yellow up here.
Y aquí en el principio, en la parte amarilla que puedes ver ahí en la pantalla.
Okay. Let us make man in our image. So we're looking at us and our.
Estamos viendo estos dos términos que dice hagamos y a nuestro.
Okay, so at least one person is talking to another person.
Y en esto se podemos ver que una persona está hablando con la otra persona.
And those two people are co-equals, or they're talking to one another as their equal people.
Y esta conversación que podemos palpar aquí son dos personas que están hablando como iguales, como personas en un mismo nivel.
Because you have our image.
Porque dice en nuestra imagen.
So you have the Father talking to Yeshua the Son.
Y tenemos al Padre hablando con Yeshua el Hijo.
And they're making man in their image.
Y ellos están creando al hombre a su imagen.
So we start off that, who is us?
Entonces hemos comenzado con de quién se refiere con nosotros.
And next question is, why did they say our image?
Y la próxima pregunta que nos hacemos es, ¿por qué ellos dijeron a nuestra imagen?
So what we're going to do in this study.
Entonces lo que vamos a hacer en este estudio
is answer who our is.
Es contestar quién es nuestra imagen.
Okay, like who is us and who is our.
Y entonces una vez más vamos a tratar de contestar la pregunta quién se refiere cuando dice nuestra imagen y a y nosotros, cuando dice nosotros.
Okay, any questions or comments so far about our study?
Y si ya hay preguntas hasta ahora que la pueden hacer ahora.
Okay, no question. And if you're on WebEx, I don't have everybody on my screen. Just unmute and say hello if you want to. You're not on the. You got to turn your camera on to ask a question.
Y no tengo a todo el mundo en la pantalla. Y si me quieren decir una pregunta, pueden abrir el micrófono y saludar. Y entonces podremos. Sí, pero para hacer la pregunta debes de encender la cámara.
So, what we're going to do now is we're going to start going through the prophecies in the book of Bereshit Genesis.
Lo que vamos a hacer ahora es que vamos a ver todas las profecías en este rollo de Bereshit, que es el Génesis.
We're going to go until 9 p.m. tonight.
Vamos a estar haciendo este estudio hasta las 9 de la noche de este día.
Okay, and like I said, if you have questions, just put up your hand.
Y como le he dicho antes, si tienen preguntas, por favor, pueden levantar la mano.
And if you're on YouTube, if YouTube takes us off, remember to go to YeshuaTube.
Y si estás en YouTube, pero Yeshua y nos tumban de YouTube, de esa plataforma puedes vernos en yeshuatube.org.
And during the day, you can listen to our radio station, WTRC Radio. And you can come out to our congregation here in Lexington, North Carolina, where you can carry a gun.
Y también puedes visitarnos en nuestra congregación en Lexington, Carolina del Norte, donde usted puede portar también su arma de fuego.
I was amazed what the governor of New York said yesterday, that they're going to come to your house and drag you out of the house and then vaccinate you. The governor said that, of New York said that yesterday.
En el día de ayer estaba sorprendido porque el gobernador de Nueva York dijo que iban a sacarte de sus hogares y vacunarlos a todos de una forma obligatoria.
All right, so the book of Genesis is a wonderful book.
El rollo de Génesis es un rollo bien interesante, bien bonito.
It contains at minimum 20 prophecies about Yeshua the Messiah.
Y contiene mínimo 20 profecías sobre Yeshua el Mesías.
Okay. If you want to turn to the Gospel of John, Yohanan chapter 5, verse 39 and 40.
Y si puedes ir y ver el versículo de Juan 5, 39 hasta el 40.
John, Yohanan chapter 5, verse 39 and 40.
Una vez más, Jesús Yohanan, Juan, en el Brihad Asha, capítulo 5, versos del 39 al 40.
Give you a second to find that.
Vamos a dar unos segundos para encontrar.
John, chapter 5, verse 39 and 40.
Una vez más, esto es en Juan 5, 39 al 40.
This is from Yeshua the Messiah himself. He said, you keep examining the Tanakh because you think that in it you have an eternal life. The very scriptures bear witness to me, but you won't come to me in order to have life. Okay, so Yeshua said in verse 39,
Yeshua está diciendo en el versículo 39
that the scriptures bear witness to him.
Que las escrituras han sido testigos, han dado testimonio de él.
So we're over the next few weeks we're going to try to go through, you know, all the prophecies in the Torah about Yeshua.
Y en las próximas semanas vamos a intentar de ver todas estas profecías de la Torah sobre Yeshua.
This study might be quite long, but if you miss any part, they'll always be on our website.
Y ese estudio puede ser extenso, pero si te pierdes de unos de ellos, entonces puedes verlo todo en nuestra página de internet.
And our website is bgmctv.org.
Y nuestra página de internet es la bgmctv.org.
Or bethgoyim.org right here at the top of the screen.
O también puedes vernos en betgoin.org.
Okay. So Yeshua says the Torah, the scriptures bear witness about him.
Yeshua dice que la Torah ha dado testimonio sobre él.
Okay, the prophecies of Yeshua, what we're going to see in our very first one, go all the way back to the Garden of Eden, the Gan Eden.
Y entonces lo que vamos a ver ahora es todas estas profecías sobre Yeshua remontan directamente hasta el Jardín del Edén, allá atrás.
Okay, so let's go on to slide number 8. We're going to now go back to Genesis, Bereshit 3, verse 15.
Y viendo a esta diapositiva número 8, vamos a ver, volver a Bereshit, a Génesis, en esta ocasión, ver el capítulo 3, verso 15.
Because Yeshua said the Torah talks about himself.
Porque Yeshua dice que la Torah habla sobre él.
The scriptures bear witness to him, says Messiah Yeshua.
El Mesías Yeshua dice que la Torah y la Tanaj son testimonios, dan testimonio sobre él.
Bereshit, Genesis, chapter 3, verse 15.
Y una vez más, Bereshit, eso es Génesis 3, verso 15.
I'm going to read it both in the Complete Jewish Bible and then the better version, the NASB.
Lo voy a leer en ambas versiones, en la Biblia completa judía y en la NASB.
I will put animosity between you and the woman, and between your descendants and her descendants. He will bruise your head, and you will bruise his heel. Okay, what the CJB is missing, it doesn't say it well, it says it okay.
Y lo que la Biblia completa judía está diciendo, lo dice que está bien, pero no está 100%.
Now, just to let everybody know, the Complete Jewish Bible comes from the JPS, the Jewish Publication Society's translation of the Old Testament, the Tanakh.
Y pues para el récord y la información, la Biblia completa judía viene, ha sido la traducción, viene directamente de la traducción que hace la sociedad judía.
And what they did in a lot of times in the Complete Jewish Bible.
Y lo que muchas veces hacen, o lo que han hecho de la Biblia completa judía.
Is they try to hide these passages about the Mashiach.
Es que han tratado de esconder estos versículos que hablan sobre el Mesías.
So they say they're going to put animosity between your descendants and her descendants. That's okay, but it's not really strong enough.
Y cuando dice va a poner una enemistad entre tu descendencia y la de ella, está bien, pero no está tan fuerte como debería.
Now, in the NASB version here in the lower part of your screen.
Y aquí, como usted está mirando en la parte de abajo de su pantalla, en la NASB.
I'm going to read it to you in English. I'm going to read the English version, okay?
Voy a leer la parte en inglés. Usted escuche, por favor.
And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise him on the heel. So you see, in the yellow here.
Como puedes ver en la parte amarilla aquí.
That between your seed and her seed is in this version.
Cuando dice entre su semilla y la de, o su simiente y la de ella.
And in the Complete Jewish Bible version, it's between your descendants and her descendants. That's not really good enough.
Y en la Biblia completa judía dice entre tu descendencia y la de ella. No está lo suficientemente correcto.
Because the seed of the man is what comes out of his body in relations with his wife.
Porque la simiente del hombre es lo que sale del hombre cuando tiene sus cuando se une a su mujer.
And her seed is her eggs that are in her body.
Y la simiente de ella se está refiriendo a los óvulos de la mujer.
So in the verse 15, there's going to be something put between the two seeds so that they don't get together.
Entonces, entre esa, en esta parte, lo que va a suceder es que hay algo que se va a interponer para que estos dos no se unan, para que estas simientes no se unan.
Excuse me for coughing there. I'm trying to take a pill. Take so many pills during the day. One second, everybody.
Un segundo, por favor.
Let me just get these down instead of rushing.
Y en estos comerciales, usted continúa escuchando W13Radio.com.
One more second, everybody. Listen to WTRCRadio.com. All right, one second. All right, thank you for waiting. So in the NASB, you see something much stronger in that version.
Y en la NASB usted puede ver algo más fuerte en esa versión.
So there's going to be enmity or animosity between the two seeds.
Entonces va a haber una enemistad o una separación entre esas dos simientes.
And if that happens, then a baby won't be made.
Y si eso ocurre, entonces un bebé no puede ser formado.
The sperm has to fertilize the egg to form the beginnings of a baby.
Y en otros términos, el esperma debe de fertilizar el óvulo para que entonces pueda procrear un bebé.
Okay, but what this is a prophecy about a virgin birth.
Y lo que se está tratando es que eso es una profecía de un nacimiento virginal.
Because this will go along with the prophecies in Yeshayahu and Isaiah.
Porque esto es lo que hace conexión con la profecía de Isaías.
About the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son.
Hablando sobre que una virgen va a dar a luz y concebirá y dará a luz un hijo.
Now, what is so very fascinating about this first prophecy?
Lo que es fascinante de esta primera profecía
is Adam and Chava have not even left the Garden of Eden yet, a Gan Eden.
Es que Adán y Eva no habían dejado todavía el jardín.
So, what is this animosity?
Entonces, ¿qué es esta enemistad?
In the Hebrew, it is H342.
En el hebreo es la palabra H342.
It is Eva.
Es Hebrew. La palabra Eva.
Okay, Eva. And it means enmity and hatred between the two seeds.
La definición dice que es una enemistad y un odio entre las dos simientes.
If that occurs, there won't be a baby.
Entonces, si esto ocurre, no va a haber una fertilización, un bebé.
Because the egg will not get fertilized by the sperm.
Porque entonces el esperma no va a fertilizar los óvulos.
So here in Bereshit Genesis 3:15, we have the prophecy about a virgin birth in our first prophecy.
Entonces aquí podemos ver que en Génesis 3:15 tenemos la primera profecía de un nacimiento virginal.
Okay, and the word for enmity or animosity is eba. It means hatred between the two parts.
Y esta palabra de esta enemistad o odio entre los dos entre las dos simientes, su palabra es eba.
Now, hold your place in Bereshit in Genesis and go on to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 1.
Pongo una marca ahí en Génesis y vayamos a Mateo 1, 23 hasta el versículo 25.
Matiahu, Matthew chapter 1, verse 23 to 25.
Matai, Matiahu, capítulo 1, verso 23 al 25.
Give a second to get there.
Un segundo para llegar ahí.
All right, so Matthew chapter 1, Matiahu chapter 1, verse 23 to 25. The virgin will conceive and bear a son, and they will call him Immanuel. When Joseph awoke, he did what the angel of Jehovah had told him to do. He took Miriam home to be his wife, but he did not have sexual relations with her until she had given birth to a son, and he named him Yeshua. Okay, so in verse 23,
en el verso 23,
we have the Yeshiahu reference of the virgin will conceive and bear a son.
Tenemos la profecía de Yeshiahu de Isaías, que la Virgen concebirá y dará a luz un hijo.
And then in verse 25,
y en el versículo 25,
we have the confirmation that Joseph did not have sexual relations with Miriam until she gave birth to Yeshua.
Tenemos la confirmación de que Joseph, José, no tuvo relaciones con su esposa Miriam hasta que dio a luz a Yeshua.
So let's read those three verses again.
Leamos una vez más esos tres versículos.
The virgin will conceive and bear a son. They will call him Immanuel. When Joseph awoke, he did what the angel of Jehovah had told him to do. He took Miriam home to be his wife. But he did not have sexual relations with her until she had given birth to a son, and he named him Yeshua. Okay, so we have the confirmation that Joseph did not have sexual relations with Miriam until after she gave birth.
Una vez más, podemos ver la confirmación de que Joseph José no tuvo relación sexual con su esposa Miriam hasta después que ella dio a luz a Yeshua.
And for those religions that don't believe that Miriam never had relations, they might want to read verse 25.
Y para aquellos religiosos que creen que Miriam no tuvo relaciones sexuales, pues debe de leer ese verso 25.
The Coptic Christians do not believe that Miriam ever had sexual relations with her husband Joseph. That contradicts verse 25.
Los coptos religiosos, cristianos coptos, no creen que Miriam tuvo relaciones con Joseph. Eso contradice directamente el verso 25.
Any questions or comments so far?
¿Alguna pregunta hasta ahora o comentario?
Okay. Also, this is confirmed if we want to turn to Galatians chapter 4.
También va a confirmar si queremos, podemos ver en Gálatas, capítulo 4.
So turn to Galatians 4, verse 4 and 5.
Entonces vayamos a Gálatas 4, verso 4 y 5.
Galatas, chapter 4, verse 4 and 5.
Gálatas. Gálatas 4, verso 4 y 5.
Gálatas, capítulo 4, versículo 4 al 5. All right, everybody got it? All right. When the appointed time arrived, God sent forth his son, who was born from a woman, born into a culture in which legalistic perversion of the Torah was the norm, so that he might redeem those in subjection to this legalism, and thus enable us to be made God's sons. Okay, so, but we're not going to be focusing on the legalistic perversion of Torah, because we still know Torah is in effect, Matthew 5, verse 18.
Y no nos vamos a enfocar en lo que habla del legalismo de la Torá, porque sabemos que la Torá está aún vigente de acuerdo a Mateo 5, 16, 17 y 18.
18. Okay, so God is talking against the homosexual community here in verse 4. The baby was born of a woman.
Y aquí se está hablando directamente en contra de esa comunidad homosexual porque la mujer, el niño tiene que nacer de una mujer.
Because men cannot have babies.
Porque los hombres no pueden tener niños.
Because they don't have ovaries.
No pueden dar a luz a los niños porque no tienen ovarios.
Okay. But verse 4, let's read the beginning of verse 4 again.
Una vez más, vamos a leer el comienzo del versículo 4.
But when the appointed time arrived, God sent forth his son. Okay, so what we started with back in our before we went into the book of Genesis.
Con lo que comenzamos antes de irnos en Génesis.
Remember, we started off in Genesis Bereshit 1, verse 26.
Recuerden que nosotros comenzamos con Génesis 1, 26.
And it said, "Let us make man in our image."
Y que dice, hagamos al hombre a nuestra imagen y nuestra semejanza.
Okay, so that's the Father and the Son.
Ahí se refleja el Padre y el Hijo.
Okay, so now in Galatians 4,
Entonces ahora en Gálatas 4.
we see Rav Scholl saying that the Father sent forth his Son.
Estamos viendo que el Padre envía por el Hijo.
Born of a woman, not with a man.
Say that again, Ra.
Born of a woman, not with a man.
Nacido de mujer y no de un hombre.
Okay, so we have a confirmation of the Matthew scripture.
Tenemos una confirmación de la escritura de Mateo.
And we have now a confirmation of the prophecy from Genesis 3, verse 15.
Y la confirmación de la profecía de que está en el rollo de Génesis 3:15.
Anybody have any questions or comments? You got any comments, Rabbi Yehoshua?
¿Comentarios o preguntas hasta ahora? No, no comments yet.
All right. Maureen?
Can you hear me okay?
Yes, I can.
All right, so this emphasis on, not born with a man and how it points towards against homosexuality because of being, those in Torah. I've got to say, I saw this, I didn't see the video, but I've seen something out there. The craziest stuff where they were a man was breastfeeding, try or pretending to breastfeed a child.
Yeah, Ben Shapiro had that on his show.
I find it so disturbing, but because nobody believes Bible anymore, and nobody believes Torah anymore. And because scripture talks against homosexuality, I'm afraid that one day soon they're going to try to ban the Bible.
They are. The Romans banned it. They burned it. Everything that was old is going to happen again.
Todo lo que
Because,
sucedió anteriormente va a suceder de nuevo.
the baby is going to do what the baby does, and it's going to latch onto a nipple. But if a man, it's a man, he doesn't have mammary glands, he's not going to produce milk for the baby.
Correct. Correct. I think Child Protective Services ought to be brought in on that personally.
Well, we're living in the times of Noah. That's why tomorrow on the Sledgehammer Show, we're going to be talking about Nimrod. Yeah. They're going to, I mean, they've already confiscated the Bibles in China. I mean, these are the days of Noah.
Estos son los tiempos de Noé.
All right. So let's go on to the next prophecy, unless anybody's got another question.
Si alguien tiene otro comentario.
Okay, so we're going back to Bereshit 3, verse 15, because there's another part we got to look at.
Y vamos a regresar a Génesis 3:15 porque hay otra parte que debemos de prestar atención.
Because there's two prophecies in the same verse.
Porque en este mismo verso bíblico hay dos profecías.
So go back to Bereshit 3, verse 15.
Regrese una vez más a Génesis 3:15.
And we're going to read it in the NASB, the bottom one here.
Y vamos a leerla en la NASB, en la parte de abajo de la pantalla.
And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise you on the head, and you shall bruise him on the heel. So we're now focusing on the second sentence in verse 15.
Nos estamos enfocando esta vez en la segunda parte de la oración en el verso 15.
He shall bruise you on the head and you shall bruise him on the heel.
Donde dice, y él te, tú le herirás en la cabeza, pero él te herirá en el calcañar.
Okay, so what does that mean?
¿Qué significa esto?
Now, in the Gan Eden, the father said to Satan, you're going to crawl on the ground.
En el jardín de Edén, el padre le dijo a Satán que se iba a arrastrar en el por el suelo.
So say a serpent creeps along the ground.
Las serpientes se arrastran por el suelo.
And can be easily crushed and bruised.
Y fácilmente pueden ser aplastadas.
Or as Robert Terena uses hedge clippers to cut snakes in half.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. So you can whack the snake with a shovel.
Entonces puedes darle o golpear la serpiente con esta pala de sembrar.
But it is easy to crush the head of a snake because they don't really have any defenses.
Pero es fácil de aplastarle la cabeza porque no tiene ningún tipo de defensa.
As long as you keep your distance from them, they can't bite you.
Y siempre y cuando usted mantenga su distancia, las serpientes no pueden morderte.
And if you cover them with a blanket, you can stop them from attacking.
Y si las cubres con una manta o algo, puedes evitar que te ataquen.
Okay, so Messiah would bruise the head of the serpent.
El Mesías iba a aplastar la cabeza de la serpiente.
And it also says you will bruise his heel.
Y también dice que él iba a morderte en el calcañal o en el tobillo.
Okay, that part ties together with another part from Bereshit 49:17.
Eso también se une a otra parte en Génesis 49:17.
In Genesis 49:17.
En Génesis 49:17.
This is Yaakov's prophecies about his sons.
Esa es la profecía sobre Jacob y sus hijos.
And that is about his son Dan.
Y esto se refiere a su hijo Dan.
So turn to Bereshit 49:17.
Así que vayamos ahí a Génesis 49:17.
Hold your place there in Bereshit 3.
Mantenga su lugar ahí en Génesis 3.
But turn to Genesis 49, Bereshit 49:17.
Y vaya a Génesis 49:17.
Dan will be a viper on the road, a horned snake in the path that bites the horse's heel so its rider falls off backwards. So this is stumbling.
Esto es sobre como caer o tropezar.
Because you can easily stumble by Satan, but Messiah never would.
Porque fácilmente puedes tropezar por las acechanzas de Satán, pero el Mesías nunca lo hará.
The bruising of the heel also speaks of the way Messiah would be crucified.
Y el morderte en el calcañal también se puede referir a cómo el Mesías fue crucificado.
Because the spike would go between the tibia and fibula on the back of the heel.
Porque esta parte de la fémula y esas partes del tobillo en el calcañal son los que unen todo eso, desde la parte del pie hasta el tobillo.
Okay, now hold your place there in Genesis 3 and turn to 1 John 3 verse 8.
Y mantén tu lugar ahí una vez más en Génesis 3 y vamos a ver en Primera de Juan 3:8.
1 John 3 verse 8.
Primera de Juan capítulo 3 verso 8.
1 John 3 verse 8, please.
Por favor, veamos en Primera de Juan 3:8.
First John 3:8 says the person who keeps on sinning is from the adversary. Because from the very beginning the adversary has kept on sinning. It was for this very reason that the Son of God appeared to destroy these doings of the adversary, to crush them.
Para aplastarlo.
To crush the head of the adversary.
Para aplastar la cabeza del adversario.
To stamp on his kingdom.
Para pararse sobre su reino.
So the Son of God appeared.
Así que el Hijo del Hombre apareció.
To destroy these doings of Hasatan the adversary.
Para eliminar estos hechos o estos actos de el adversario.
Fulfilling Genesis 3 verse 15.
Cumpliendo así la profecía de Génesis 3:15.
Now, some of these prophecies, you really do need to read the whole chapter to really get a fullness of what's going on.
Y muchas veces estos, para tener un entendimiento completo y profundo del tema, hay que ver todo el capítulo.
But as time, for time purposes, I'm only going to try to give you the verse or maybe a verse before the verse after.
Y por razones del tiempo, solamente vamos a estarte dando el versículo de lo que estamos tratando y quizás el versículo antes y después.
All right. So now let's go back to Bereshit Genesis unless there's any questions or comments about that prophecy.
Entonces volvamos a Génesis a menos que haya una pregunta o comentario.
It's very quiet in Bible study tonight. Okay.
Rav.
Yes.
Also, I was in my mind when, and I know we because of timing, talking about the heel and the and that reference of Bereshit 49. It's so also reminds me the birth of Jacob and Esau, because Jacob, his name, Yaakov, is
supplanter.
Referring also the heel in Hebrew is Yaakov. It's like two same root. And it's like the way to see it, like, oh, because he holds the heel of his brother, and that word heel of his brother is the same word that he's using by the Lord when he says, well, your heel is going to be affected by Satan and the adversary. So also referring to the descendants of Jacob, because Yeshua is descendant of that heel, that Jacob, and Jacob as Yehuda, and he's a lion of Judah. So everything is connected, even with the name and what it means, heel, Yekev, Yaakov, your descendant, your heel. It's very fascinating.
Oh, yeah, you can go real deep, but there's 350 prophecies to get through. So, but yeah, that's why I'm open for discussion, because we don't need to rush this. There's so many avenues that we can go in. You know, the supplanter, understanding that Satan tried to supplant Yeshua, but Yeshua overcame him. He bruised his head. He stepped on him like a snake. You know, there's so many avenues that we can go on.
Amen. I'm going to say it real quick in Spanish.
No problem.
Estábamos hablando de mi observación en el tema. Fue también que recordando ese versículo del 49 que hablaba de la simiente de Dan y del calcañar o lo que conocemos como el tobillo, me recordaba también cuando Jacob nace, porque Jacob, su nombre viene porque él le agarra el talón o el tobillo a su hermano Esaú, y entonces le colocan el nombre Jacob, que viene de Ekev, que es tobillo, y la misma palabra que utiliza el Señor cuando dice te va a morder en el tobillo. En las versiones dice calcañar, pero dice Yekev, que es tobillo. Entonces, podía relacionar a Jacob como que es el padre de Yehuda, y Yehuda es de donde viene Yeshua, que iba a ser golpeado. Entonces, de la simiente de ese tobillo iba a ser afectado, o sea, de la descendencia de Jacob, que significa tobillo, iba a ser afectado, que era Yeshua. Entonces, ese fue el comentario. Y el rabino decía que hay muchas, que estaba correcto, y que había muchas cosas del comentario que podíamos extendernos por ahí. Estamos refiriendo a 351 profecías que son suficientes y se va a extender. O sea, que no hay que apurarnos por el estudio en cuanto a orar ni hacerlo rápido, sino que podemos tomarnos todo el tiempo posible.
Amen. Any other questions or comments before we move on to the next prophecy?
¿Otra pregunta o comentario antes de que continuemos?
All right. So let's go on to slide number 15. Go back to Bereshit, Genesis chapter 5, verse 24.
Y vamos a la diapositiva número 15 y volvamos a Génesis esta vez, capítulo 5, verso 24.
This prophecy is about the ascension into heaven, is illustrated in the prophecy.
Y esta profecía se trata sobre
the rapture. The rapture.
Y esta profecía se trata sobre el ascender al cielo.
Okay, Genesis 5, verse 24. This is the real rapture of Yeshua.
Este es el verdadero arrebatamiento de Yeshua en Génesis 5, 24.
Hanuk walked with God, and then he wasn't there, because God took him. Okay, so this is what some people might call a rapture.
Lo que muchas personas conocen como el rapto.
But we see it's a singular person.
Pero vemos aquí que fue una persona en singular, una persona solamente.
And the two references of raptures are actually the three references of raptures.
Y de las tres referencias que tenemos de rapto,
there is only a single person each time.
Siempre es una sola persona cada vez.
You have Hanok here.
Estamos en este caso, en este versículo, Enoch.
Elisha.
Tenemos a Elías.
On the chariots of fire. Dun, 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 dun. And then Yeshua.
Que ascendió en los carruajes, en el carruaje de fuego. Y también tenemos a Yeshua.
But this prophecy is the illusion that the Father would take somebody up that was there and now he's gone.
Pero en esta profecía vemos la ilusión que el Señor crea, o no la ilusión, sino la referencia de que él iba a tomar a una persona de un punto en la tierra hacia allá arriba.
And the reference to this one is 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 4.
Y una de las referencias de esto es en primero de Reyes 19, verso 4.
That's 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 4.
Eso es primero de Reyes 19, 4.
That Hanok would not see death.
Que Enoch no iba a ver eso.
And also Hebrews, Messianic Hebrews 11, verse 5.
También en Hebreos 11, 5.
Now, the thought of this is that if he takes you, you're not dead, you're somewhere else.
Entonces, el entendimiento de eso es que si él te toma, no estás en el lugar donde estabas, sino en otra parte.
So he's not in the land of living, he's no longer in this world.
Entonces ya no está en lugar de los vivos y ni en este mundo.
So Hanok and Elisha were not in the land of the living, they weren't in this world anymore.
Entonces Enoch y Elías ya no están en la tierra de los vivientes, no están en este lugar más.
So now we look to Messiah because he would do the same thing would happen to him.
Entonces vemos al Mesías porque lo mismo le ocurrió a él.
So hold your place in Genesis and turn to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 16.
Mantén tu lugar ahí en Génesis 5 y vámonos a Marcos 16, 19.
Mark chapter 16, verse 19.
Marcos 16, verso 19.
Mark 16, verse 19.
Una vez más, Marcos 16, verso 19.
Now, this Messianic Bible study is being brought to you by Beth Glen Messianic Congregation, a place where Jew and Gentile worship Yeshua the Messiah as one people. Come out to 800 West 3rd Avenue in Lexington, North Carolina, on any Shabbat, and join us for a word, the worship, and study all day long.
Y este estudio bíblico ha sido presentado a ustedes por Beth Glen, que es un ministerio mesiánico internacional. Estamos localizados en la 800 West 3rd Avenida, Lexington, Carolina del Norte. Venga y acompañarnos a estudiar la palabra del Señor todos los Shabbat de 11 de la mañana en adelante y nos pasamos todo el día estudiando la palabra del Eterno.
So we're now talking about the real rapture of Messiah.
Entonces ahora hablando del verdadero arrebatamiento del Mesías.
In Mark chapter 16 verse 19, let's read it.
Vamos a leer Marcos 16 verso 19.
So then after he had spoken to them, the Lord Yeshua was taken up into heaven and sat at the right hand of Jehovah. Okay, so he was raptured. Wow, the rapture already happened.
Y wow, el arrebatamiento, el rapto ya ocurrió realmente.
I didn't know the rapture was real. Yeah, it was when it one person.
Y yo no sabía que el rapto era real, pero sí, sí lo fue y lo hizo con una sola persona.
Okay, so the rapture throughout all of Scripture is just one person, Hanok, Elisha, and Yeshua.
Y el rapto, el Señor sí lo hizo con una sola persona y fue consecutivamente y lo hizo con Enoch, Elías y Yeshua.
All right, moving on to the next prophecy.
Vamos a la otra profecía.
Go back to the book of Bereshit, Genesis chapter 9, verse 26 and 27.
Vamos a la otra profecía en Génesis 9, versos 26 y 27.
Genesis 9, verse 26 and 27.
Bereshit, Génesis 9, versos 26 y 27.
In this prophecy, we're going to be talking about the lineage of Yeshua.
En esta profecía vamos a ver el linaje de Yeshua.
The lineage is very important.
El linaje es muy importante.
Genesis chapter 9, verse 26 and 27.
Génesis 9, verso 26 y 27.
If you're on YouTube and you're enjoying this study, hit the thumbs up.
Y si estás en YouTube, por favor, pulgar arriba.
All right, Genesis 9, verse 26 and 27.
Génesis 9, verso 26 y 27.
Then he said, "Blessed be Jehovah, the Elohim of Shem. Canaan will be their servant. May Elohim enlarge Yafet. They will live in the tents of Shem. But Canaan will be their servant." Okay, so Messiah would be on the line of Shem.
Entonces el Mesías tiene que venir de la línea de Shem.
Shem, you'll hear a lot of Jewish people say Baruch Hashem. Blessed be the name. Shem is the name.
Entonces Shem significa nombre. Como usted ha escuchado a muchos judíos decir, Baruch Hashem es bendito sea su nombre. Pues Shem significa nombre.
Oh, you said that so nice, Baruch Hashem. Baruch. That was what I was doing before I took the pill. All right, so the important part of this part is the line of Shem.
La parte importante de esto es que la línea de Shem.
Now, hold your place there and turn to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 3.
Entonces, mantén tu lugar ahí en Génesis 9 y vamos a ver en Lucas 3.
We're going to see the lineage of Yeshua.
Vamos a ver el linaje de Yeshua.
We're going to read Luke 3, verse 23 to 38. Our key verse is verse 36.
Y vamos a leer en Lucas 3, verso 23 al 38. Y nuestro texto áureo, texto principal, es el versículo 36.
Luke chapter 3, verse 23 through 38.
Vamos a leer Lucas 3, verso 23 hasta el 38.
Give me a second to find that.
Vamos a tener unos segundos para encontrar el verso bíblico.
Everybody got it? All right. Yeshua was about 30 years old when he began his public ministry. It was supposed that he was a son of Yosef, who was of Eli, the Matat of Levi, Malchi of Yanai of Yosef, Matiyahu of Amoz, Nachum of Helsi, of Nagai, of Machat, of Matiyahu, of Shimon, of Yosef, of Yudah, of Yochanan, of Risha, of Zerubbabel, of Shaltiel, of Neri, of Malki, of Adi, of Kosam, of Elmadan, of Er, of Yeshua, of Eliezer, of Yoram, of Matat, of Levi, of Shimon, of Yehuda, of Yosef, of Yonan, of Eliakim, of Malah, of Manah, Matah, of Natan, of David, of Yishai, of Obed, of Boaz, of Salmon, of Nachshon, of Aminadab, of Admin, of Arim, Arni, of Hezron, of Peret, of Yehuda, of Yaakov, of Yitzhak, of Abraham, of Terak, of Nachor, of Sarug, of Ruel, of Peleg, of Aver, of Shelah, of Kenaan, of Akpad, of Shem, of Noach, of Lamech, of Metusholah, Hanok, Mahalalel, of Kenan, of Enosh, of Shet, Adam of God. So in your key verse, you see he's in the line of Shem.
Y en este texto principal que estamos viendo aquí dice que la línea de Shem.
Verse 36 once again.
Verso 36 una vez más.
Of Canaan, of Arpachshad, of Shem, of Noach, of Lamech. So that had to be there in Yeshua's lineage to fulfill the prophecy about Mashiach.
Y esa parte para para que se cumpla que es el Mesías tenía que venir de del linaje de Shem.
So there you have it right there in the Gospel of Luke. That's why you have all those ridiculous names and there's a lot more to the names.
Y ahí tenemos por eso tenemos toda esta lista de todos esos nombres para comprobar esto.
So you're saying, you know, when you're reading it, sometimes you're like, why am I reading all these names?
Y cuando lo lees, quizás dirías, o te quejas, ¿por qué estoy leyendo todos estos nombres?
Well, one, you have to have it there to prove of who the Mashiach would be.
Y lo tienes, una parte de esto es para probar que quién es el Mesías.
Any questions or comments?
¿Preguntas o comentarios?
I thought there'd be more talking during this study.
And again, I'm coming with probably with the same thing because, right, you're right, Rob. When people, including me, people, you know, we ask the question, why am I reading this? But and everything start again in Bereshit 5 with all those names again, and it's interesting when we take a time. Separate name by name, also dates, because in Bereshit 5, it gives us the date, and including all these names that is right here, well, not everything, but till Noah. But it's interesting to read this part as well, understanding that Luke is doing exactly the same thing. Also, of course, proving that Yeshua comes from Shem, but at the same time, showing how Jewish is Luke in this particular way, showing all the lineage, very very nice. This is very Jewish, and again, if we look at this, and the meanings of each name, is it have to be another story, you know, another hours and hours. Of good studies, you know, of the Bible. So I think it's very interesting and any proof 100% who Yeshua is, it proved that he is a Messiah, and it's not only like a regular thing, because also people can take this you know, in a regular language, and it says, well, in this particular lineage it says this, but in another particular lineage it says another thing. Another line, they don't, you know, as I say, we can pass hours and another biblical study talking about names, because we can prove either or who Yeshua is, you know.
Well, when you take the names of Genesis 5.
Cuando tomamos los nombres de Génesis 5.
And there's a study on a website on this one.
Y de este tema tenemos un estudio bíblico en la página de internet.
You take each name in its meaning.
Se toma cada nombre y su significado.
It points directly to Messiah.
Y te va a apuntar directamente al Mesías.
I'll say it in English, and we'll try to do it in Spanish, but I'm going to say it first in English. The Genesis 5 names, when you put them in English, it says, man appointed mortal sorrow. The blessed God shall come down, teaching his death brings a sparing comfort. So on the website it is in English and Spanish.
Y si te quieres ver más de esto, de este estudio bíblico con los nombres y los significados, a qué apuntan todos esos nombres de Génesis 5, hay un estudio bíblico en la página de internet, bethgoim.org, en sección de educación.
All right, yeah. Each name is very important to the validity of Messiah's coming.
Y cada nombre es importante para el cumplimiento de la venida de Mesías.
Each name tells its own story.
Cada nombre está contando su propia historia.
Each lineage gives another story.
Cada linaje está hablando su propia historia.
If you were to take this Gospel of Luke lineage,
si fueras a tomar este linaje del Evangelio de Lucas,
and take each grouping of names, it would tell you a fascinating story.
Y tomando cada grupo de nombres te va a dar una historia fascinante.
So take each grouping of name, look up the meaning of each name, and I'm sure you'll find an interesting, powerful story.
Y si tomas todos estos nombres y los separas por sus grupos, seguro que vas a encontrar una historia bien fascinante y poderosa.
Any other questions or comments before we go on to the next prophecy?
Y si hay otra pregunta o comentario antes de irnos a la próxima profecía.
All right, go back to Bereshit, Genesis chapter 12, verse 2 and 3.
Regresemos a Génesis y vamos a ver en Génesis 12, versos 2 y 3.
This is about the seed of Abraham that it will bless all the nations.
Esto se trata de la simiente de Abraham que bendecirá a todas las naciones.
That the Messiah, the Mashiach, would have to come from the lineage of Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov.
Que el Mesías tenía que venir del linaje de Abraham, Isaac y Jacob.
Genesis 12, verse 2 and 3.
Génesis 12, verso 2 y 3.
I will make of you a great nation. I will bless you. I will make your name great. You are to be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, but I will curse anyone who curses you. And by you, all the families of the earth will be blessed. Now, this is about the lineage of Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov.
Una vez más, esto se habla sobre el linaje de Abraham, Yitzhak, y Jacob.
That the Messiah would have to come from this lineage.
El Mesías tenía que venir de ese linaje.
And it's the key to the prophecy about Messiah would be, by you, all the families of the earth will be blessed.
Y la clave conectando al Mesías aquí sería que por de ti o por ti serán benditas todas las naciones de la tierra.
So the Messiah would have to be a Hebrew.
El Mesías tenía que ser hebreo.
Or some people call them Israelites.
Algunas personas los llaman israelita.
It is incorrect, really, to call them Jews because that's only from Judah.
Es incorrecto realmente llamarlos judíos porque eso sería solamente la tribu de Judá.
Now, Yeshua does come from the line of the tribe of Judah.
Aunque el Mesías sí viene de la tribu de Judá.
But to call the people living in Israel just Jews is really inaccurate.
Pero llamarle a las personas que viven en Israel solamente judíos es algo que no es correcto.
Okay, so we will be focusing on by all the families of the earth will be blessed.
Nos estamos enfocando en que por ti todas las naciones de la tierra van a ser bendecidas.
So turn to Galatians chapter 3 verse 8 for the fulfillment.
Para ver el cumplimiento vamos a leer en Gálatas 3, 8.
Galatians chapter 3, verse 8.
Una vez más, Gálatas 3, verso 8.
Galatians chapter 3, verse 8.
Gálatas 3:8.
Galatians chapter 3, verse 8.
Una vez más, Gálatas 3:8.
Give me a second to find that, because sometimes Galatians gets hard to find.
Una vez más, vamos a darle la oportunidad para que busquen el verso de Gálatas 3:8, un poquito complicado a veces encontrar Gálatas.
Give me a second to stretch out my neck here. All right, Galatians 3, verse 8. Also, the Tanakh, foreseeing that God would consider the Gentiles righteous when they live by trusting and being faithful, told the good news to Abraham in advance by saying, in connection with you, all the goyim would be blessed. So the fulfillment of Yeshua is all the goyim would be blessed. Believing in Yeshua, all the goyim would be blessed.
Porque creyendo en Yeshua, todos los goyim van a ser bendecidos.
But they have to do two things.
Pero deben de hacer dos cosas.
Well, three things.
En realidad, tres.
Believe in Yeshua.
Creer en Yeshua.
Trust that he is Messiah.
Confiar que él es el Mesías.
And what does it mean to be faithful?
¿Y qué quiere decir ser fiel?
How are you faithful to God?
¿Cómo es que eres fiel a Dios?
You have to follow the Torah.
Tienes que seguir la Torah.
Because if you're just going to do whatever you want to do, you're not being faithful.
Porque si solamente vas a hacer lo que tú quieres, entonces no vas a tener fe en.
Okay, so the fulfillment here is verse 8. It says, in connection with you, Yeshua, all the goyim would be blessed.
Y en este cumplimiento de la profecía, en esta conexión, es que por medio de Yeshua, todas las naciones van a ser bendecidas.
Does everybody see that?
¿Será que todos pueden ver esto? Right.
Yes, sir.
And also a interesting verse, because the part of the good news that everybody knows as a gospel, right there, it shows that it was telling before to Abraham. So, what is that means?
Yeah.
So it's a good verse for the New Testament people to save it, because to prove that the good news or the gospel was shown to Abraham, it proved that it's the Torah, you know, not only like, you know, Matthew, you know, John and Luke. Like, people think it's only those scriptures, but as we start this study, everything, all the Tanakh testify about Yeshua. So that's how we prove that Yeshua is the Messiah.
And remember, Yeshua says, before Abraham was, I am.
Amén. Y así, como tenemos que recordar que cada vez Yeshua había mencionado, antes de Abraham, yo fui. O yo soy.
Yo soy. I don't like soy. It's too salty for me. Duck sauce is much better. All right.
Okay.
It's one thing we miss about New Jersey. Kosher Chinese food.
Oh, yes. Big time. Algo que extrañamos es esa comida china kosher de New Jersey.
Yeah, well, you don't want to be up there now. They're locking everything down up there. So said the news today.
Las noticias están diciendo que están cerrando todo allá arriba.
All right. We'll do one more for tonight's study.
Un verso más por el estudio bíblico de esta noche.
Oh, actually, we're still in this one. I forgot I did the second one. Turn to Acts chapter 3, verse 25 and 26.
Vamos a hacer la otra parte. Vamos a Hechos 3, verso 25 y 26.
Hechos, Acts chapter 3, verse 25 and 26.
Hechos, capítulo 3, verso 25 y 26.
And we'll stop after this one. I don't want to rush any of this study. What you're seeing here took me 4 hours today.
Toda esta parte me tomó 4 horas en el día de hoy. No quiero ajorar o apurar el estudio bíblico. Tomémonos esto.
And if you want a copy of the PowerPoint, send me an email at info@bethcoin.org.
Si quieres una copia de la diapositiva, mándame un correo electrónico a info@bethcoin.org.
And hit the donate button.
Y por favor, presiona el botón de donar.
Okay, last part of tonight's study, Acts 3, verse 25 and 26. You are the sons of the prophets. And you are included in the covenant which God made with our fathers when he said to Abraham, by your seed will all the families of the earth be blessed. So it is to you first that God has sent his servant, whom he has raised up, so that he might bless you by turning each one of you from your evil ways. That's not being nice, Yeshua. How are you going to win anybody to the Lord that way? Okay. So here Yeshua is talking about himself being the seed of Abraham.
Aquí se está hablando de que Yeshua es la simiente de Abraham.
In verse 26, he says, so it is to you first that Jehovah has sent his servant whom he has raised up.
Entonces so, está hablando aquí en este versículo que enviando a su siervo fue levantado, así mismo como fue resucitado su hijo.
So this is the Talmudim talking about Yeshua. I think I misquoted it before. This is the Talmudim talking about Yeshua because Yeshua is back in heaven in Acts already.
Y esto es un Talmudim, un estudiante de Yeshua, un discípulo, porque Yeshua ya había sido raptado al cielo.
So
he was raptured already.
Yeah, he was raptured. Yeah. All right, he got beamed up by the Enterprise. Beam me up, Scotty. Okay. Any questions or comments? We're going to conclude tonight's study with this part here.
¿Alguna pregunta o comentario? Vamos a concluir el estudio por ahora, esta noche.
Anybody bored of this study already? I think it's great.
¿Será que están aburridos? Yo creo que es fascinante.
I have a comment.
Go ahead.
When you talked about Yeshua being raptured, he died first. Right?
That is correct.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then he came back again. He's like a cat. He had 9 lives.
Oh, I know that. But, you know, what these people don't believe is that everybody's just going to get whisked away and nobody's going to have to go through, you know, trials and the end.
Well, they haven't read then the last book called Revelation.
Yeah.
It's not a happy book, but it ends with a good thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We win.
Yeah. 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 But yeah.
Well, you're going to see a lot of trouble soon. Israel is saying they're up to, anyway, well, let's close in prayer. And we're going to talk about that on the Sledgehammer Show tomorrow. Called Nimrod and the One World Government.
Mm.
All right, let's close in prayer. Go ahead.
Mantenga su conexión. Mañana en el show del martillo vamos a estar hablando de Nimrod y el nuevo orden mundial.
We'll be streaming it live at 7:15 tomorrow night on yeshuatube.org because YouTube would definitely kick us off after this.
Y vamos a estar transmitiendo todo eso directamente y en vivo mañana a las 7:15 por yeshuatube.org.
But we are put our videos on Vimeo, Brighteon, and now BitChute.
Y estamos colocando nuestros videos en Vimeo, en Brighteon y BitChute.
And brand new tube, the one in Europe. They like us in Europe.
Oh, yeah? Nice.
Yeah, they do. They watch like 150 times.
Nice.
Hit the donate button.
Por favor, presiona el botón de donar mientras puedas.
All right, let's close in some prayer. Thank you, Lord, for your blessing. Thank you, Lord, for your word as a lamp unto our feet. Yeshua, you're so amazing and wonderful. Give us the power to do more for your kingdom. Raise us up and give people a heart to want to do more for your kingdom. In your name, Yeshua, and everybody said, Amen. Shalom, everybody.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into His eternal word, not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of His kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to Him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website, where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.